Only a day into the new job and Speaker Peter Slipper is being attacked for deserting the coalition and handing more power to Federal Labor. And he's being investigated for allegedly rorting his travel spending.
The so-called King Rat has gone underground.
More questions about Mr Slipper, his travels, his use of entitlements, his conduct should go to the Prime Minister.
Hiding in a Canberra cafe today, Peter Slipper's been slammed a traitor, a turncoat and a troublemaker, with at best a colourful past.
Given the fact he's under investigation for travel claims, do you think it's right that he's Speaker?
The government ready for mudslinging from the opposition.
Of course they will smear him, they will dig, they will get dirty.
Harry Jenkins came to Parliament today to clear out his office. The opposition leader claims the former Speaker was forced to take one for the team. But Mr Slipper's mates deny they were involved in any backroom deals.
My role has been non-existent.
Some Labor insiders say that installing Peter Slipper as Speaker was politically a very cunning move that completely blindsided the coalition. Julia Gillard now finishes the year in a much stronger position than a few months ago, and they say Tony Abbott would have done the same thing to win an extra vote.
I just don't do that kind of thing. It's not my style.
The suggestion that we were somehow, actively trying to engage another person is wrong.
Oh, really? Rob Oakeshott claims Tony Abbott offered him the coalition's support if he was nominated for Speaker.
It was all in the same phone call that the offer was made and the offer was rejected. Everything that went wrong last time, he was willing to change that position.
This is some good news in that the government is one vote closer to poker machine reform.
Amanda Hart, 10 News. Cautious.